To the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence for the sick, handicapped, departed, and military personnel of this community. Thank you. Roll call, please.
Mike Fulmer.
Here.
Bruce Valericci.
Here.
Bill Henderson.
Here.
Neil Lyon. Joe Bossman.
Here.
Joe Verducci.
Here.
Bert Cherry.
Here.
Mayor Pascal Blazio.
Here.
Solicitor Thomas McDermott.
Here.
Engineer Joe Sykes.
Here.
Borough Manager Lori Collins.
Here.
Police Chief Chad King.
Here.
Fire Chief Phil Chilio. South Bridge EMS Dennis Gonta.
Here.
Call our first visitor up, Ron Hurt. Yes, please.
I'd like to thank you for hearing me. My name's Ron Hurt. I live up on Lafayette Street, up here in Bridgeville. I'm having a problem with dogs in the yard. The owners, actually. I had dogs for 30 years of my life. I never had a problem, never took the dogs onto other people's property. I had hedgerow up that was probably this high all the way around the house. They cut through the hedges, it was all over. I put a very expensive fence in now because my hedges in the front actually are viewed from the dogs and the owners let them go. I put up a sign that says, please be respectful to keep them off the lawn. They let the dogs go in the sign. So then a police officer came up and I asked them I asked this young lady here what I could do, and she said if you have a no trespassing sign, that's probably the only time they could do anything. Put the no trespassing, I even had bad signs up so that it would get their attention. They actually let them go on the signs and on my fence. I called the police the one day. I told a couple people, please, they give me that, not my doggy. I says, I have video cameras now. I says, you're on video. And they blow me off. Make unseen gestures. Last one came, and I told one, and I didn't want to get involved with the police. The lady come down, and she's got one of them long leashes. The dog's up here, and she's going like this. Dog is on the sign. She keeps walking. And I says, miss, you know, there's signs there. Say no trespassing. And she says, my dog, I'll show you on video. I have video cameras that videotape it. She said, I said, you want them to call me? She goes, go ahead. So I called the police. The policeman responded. He tried to tell me, don't make a disturbance. You know, it could cause you problems with people. Don't talk to me usually anyhow. But then he suggested I put mulch around the fence so the dogs can go. And I says, no, this is my property. I just want some respect. Now, I don't know what you guys can do for it. I don't want to be bothering the police to come up there. Can't they do something even about leash laws where if they're standing on the curb, they can't go in my yard? Right now, they got those leashes that are, I don't know what they are, 30 foot, 40 foot. Earlier, they went halfway out in the yard, the neighbor's yard. She stood there and watched it. She went and picked up, but then her dog went up on the porch, running on her porch, and I thought,
running on your porch?
They let them in my yard. They let them down my fence in the yard whenever they come. And then we asked them to stop. This is one of the other neighbors. We have the flat spot that's Lafayette Bank and I don't know what the upper street is there. Okay, yeah. And they just walk around. And they're coming from Upper St. Clair. They come from all over. Right. We've already counted like 60 people and most of them don't just have one dog. I just want some respect. This is my property. I don't have to. Why should I have to yell and cause a problem? I don't want to. I would go in their yard and just.
It's
we had a couple
of
people. This is my other neighbor, Patty. She's next door. She's asked them and told them, explained to them. She has raised flower beds, and the dogs go in the flower beds.
you're on the corner of Bank and Lafayette.
No, Lafayette and Elizabeth.
Lafayette and Elizabeth.
The gray brick.
Okay. And Patty is?
Next door to me on one street.
And there's supposed to be another neighbor.
And there was another neighbor coming that's on the corner of Lafayette and Elizabeth, the landscaper.
What's his name?
Sir, a lot of what you're describing with messing with your bushes and whatnot and with dogs, that's actually the civil trespass on your property. And if they're affecting three of yous, you collectively, you might want to collectively get together and do it.
Why does?
Because the government is not the one who has the power over every dispute. When you have a property dispute with a neighbor, you're trespassing. If they're doing stuff in your yard, that's a trespass. And what folks do is they sue each other. They get a lawyer, or they, without a lawyer, you don't need a lawyer. You can go to the magistrate and file a civil claim against them for trespassing in your yard.
They can't make a leash law or something, so they can't do it. See, I mean, a short leash.
That we have to look into whether they have a limit on how long a leash could be.
That doesn't solve your problem.
Right.
Well, if they walk and they have a short leash, then they can keep it out. But they let them loose and they take off and run down.
Yeah, what they're doing is they're still disrespecting your yard.
Yes.
And you don't, whether it's short or long, you don't want them disrespecting your yard.
And the lady that did that, she went to every yard on the street. The wife followed to figure out where she lived. She ended up living on the other end of our street. Mm-hmm. She hit every yard all the way up Bank Street and then Winfield and then went in her yard and the dog never stopped. And that's who I called the police on.
Other than what our solicitor recommended and us taking a look at the leash law, but except we do have a leash law, and the only thing we could do is make it a shorter leash. And I don't know if that's something that,
what's not even, the people in the street, right. They're caught in where they're all coming from. There's just too many dogs.
Right.
I know there's a lot of people with dogs, but as many that are coming down our street.
Right.
Sure, at least won't even matter.
Yeah, they're still going to, if somebody's wants a dog to do it from here to the umbrella over there, they're going to go from here.
But then they'd have to walk in the yard.
I've sat on my neighbor's porch and watched people walk down my street and let their dog do the business in my front yard on a short leash. They don't care.
Well, the other gentleman that was coming down, he was so mad. He was standing there in his yard that they let the dog go in the tree right beside him. He was talking to his wife, and the guy stood there listening to his conversation for like 10 minutes. He says, "Really? You can't even see that we're talking here." And then another one came up on the other side of him an hour or two later. And he says to him, "What are you doing?" He says, "It's not my fault, it's the dog's."
You should have a bag to pick up after your dog.
He picked it up. You can't pick it. You can pick the solid better. You can't pick the litter.
She wants to say something.
Yes.
If you have an ordinance, about leashes, that a dog must be on a leash.
Yes.
Can't there be an ordinance that it can't go to the bathroom in everybody's yard?
Yeah, I believe that's on the board.
I think the leash law is a state law. I don't know that we have an ordinance about that.
Okay.
Dog can't run at large.
We have been running at large, right. But there are laws that overlap on the state level. That's why I want to take a look at it. And if we have the power to do something, I'll look at our ordinance. Are you allowed to put a cleanup provision in an ordinance if we can?
Yeah.
But you can't clean up some liquid, like it says. And that caused, I've received my front lawn 4 times already.
Right.
I've replaced all the hedgerow and everything with fences.
Let me confirm that. This is about liquid waste.
What's about both?
But this isn't about people not picking up. They're leaving their liquid waste there.
Some don't pick it up. If I'm there, they pick it up. I watch
some. Some don't even do that.
Some don't even do that, yes. You always find it in your yard.
Yeah. We have the same property in front of the railroad station, in front of the caboose. And we did put signs up. We wrote them ourselves, however, did them ourselves. And one of them says, "No trespassing." It has cut the amount, but the people still do it.
You have the signs that you say you're on camera. You have the signs saying, too, you're on camera.
Unfortunately, the cameras that we have don't focus.
Let's take a look at it.
Okay. We can add.
Thank you for hearing.
Thank you.
Excuse me, sir.
I'm sorry.
I'm curious. They sell products like to keep animals out of like.
Try it.
Really?
I put cayenne pepper by the fence. We put that It says gets rid of deers, rabbits, any animals. Put that there, nothing stops on that.
Yeah, you want to come look in my garage? I spent a lot of money on that stuff for nothing.
We tried, and we asked first. We put up nice signs, we said please, and it doesn't matter. They ignore you. That last one I called, like I said, she just walked down like this with her head up. The dog stopped where you're at, and she kept like this, walking like this, like she didn't see it. And then she had to pull it when she goes, and I showed them on a video and that. And that's, I didn't have signs on, 24-hour surveillance, and it's...
All right.
I'm sorry.
Yep.
Okay, thank you.
All right. Mary Weiss.
First of all, you're all, everybody here, all of you here, are invited tomorrow night at 7 o'clock to come to the old railroad station. Our historian, John Euler, has us up to the high school in 1927. I don't know when we'll ever get to 1960, but we're working on it. But at 7 o'clock tomorrow night, and that was the real turning point between a high school class, a graduation, and actual yearbooks, things like that. So hopefully you'll all come, or some of you will. We'd love to have you. We also are selling raffle tickets. The company for which I work donated 4 seats, a parking pass for August the 3rd, which is a Thursday night, and we are mixing the thing up a little bit. If you win our ticket, it's only because you won the state lottery ticket also, and which means we had only 250 tickets that we're selling. They're $5 a ticket, so I have plenty with me tonight. Some of you have already been helping us, and we thank you very, very much. I'm changing the subject at this point because of something that almost happened to me at lunchtime today. Going up Station Street Hill, this is the second time in a week that there's been almost an incident. A week ago, a car waiting to make the left turn onto Washington waited and waited and waited, and four cars behind him cut around him, came straight down the hill, and two of us had to back up to let them. Fortunately, we had the room to do that. Today, it was getting into the crosswalk, turning left on Washington from Station Street. I missed that lady by a foot. You cannot see her until you're in the crosswalk. I'm advocating that you do something. One would be left turn, lights all 4 ways at the main street. And for the people who live and work and have businesses on Chartiers, a left turn signal, please. That's not asking very much, but it may mean a lot of safety factors would be faced. The other thing I want to ask about, Friday's paper, Remavia Road, 600 more houses for sale. They're ready. That's 3 cars average per household. And I think it's high time that pressure was brought to bear on PennDOT, Upper St. Clair, and South Fayette to do a double decker, 4 lanes each way, and get the people over to I-79 as quickly as possible. Or if they can get over, if they ever do the new highway, get to that. But not tear everything up for Bridgeville, and it's a disgrace. And I'm tired of it, the taxpayers are tired of it, people who go to vote are tired of it. I just urge you, bring pressure. Certainly, Upper St. Clair could put in $5 million, South Fayette $5 million, and PennDOT certainly has the other $5 million. But please, they have to start doing something. No more Band-Aids. We have enough of them. Thank you.
Thanks, Mayor. John McCann, please.
I have good news.
Yes, sir. Tell us about the cars.
This year, at Bridgeville Downey Avenue Park, during the Downey Avenue, we had 133 cars. 125 were registered. But that put near 200 people on the street, down and through, the vendors buying food, etc. So it was well attended. It didn't cost Bridgeville anything other than a port-a-john this year. And the reason being is I had sponsorship for the class awards. Mr. Goodiducci sponsored the Best of Show. War-a-john, we'll give this to you shortly. Did the dash plaques. The police department did run the registration and the flyers, but we thank them for that too. But all in all, it was really a good affair. And I did have enough for everybody. Joe? Mr. McNerman?
Thank you, sir. It's a very nice collection.
Bruce. He already has one here in a second. I did, I got you one.
Oh, okay.
And we want to thank Lynette. This is the second year that she's worked the registration table, and she's gotten good at it. So therefore, thank you all. We have a good day.
Thank you. Thanks for putting it together.
Paul Fryer, please.
The last time I was here, I was asking you guys about it. Excuse me. I'll just go like this. Sorry. I was asking you about the left turn lane in front of the Bethany Church going into Chartier Street. There was some, a difference of opinion about whether PennDOT knew about it or not. I'd just like to know if, since I brought it to your attention, if you have notified PennDOT.
We have a meeting next week.
And I talked with my cameraman, he believes it's on plan, but yes. We have a meeting next week, we're going to verify that with them.
Excellent, that's wonderful. Well, I'd like to suggest something else to you guys as well. I believe one of you mentioned that this seven-lane bridge might be as much as $4 million. And I think that requesting things like the left-turn stacking lane and a wider radius on this area so cars can get into the Bridgeville Business District are in a small amount compared to the importance. But the other thing I want to mention to you, when the last time I was down at PennDOT, I mentioned to the guys about the cars that sit on New Route 50, there are two lanes there. When the seven-lane bridge is built, the one lane is going to be exclusively for the cars going up Chartier Street. However, the other half of the second lane, is going to be half people that want to come to Bridgeville. In other words, this first lane, obviously, the present left lane now is exclusively Bridgeville. The present right lane is going to be now 50% going up Chartier Street and 50% coming to Bridgeville. The point I'm trying to make is when people come off of New Route 50 onto Washington Pike, the speed of that turn is about 15 miles an hour. And I mentioned this to the two engineers at PennDOT, that this turn from the bridge right up to Chartier Street should also be radius large enough so that the cars aren't hitting their brakes and dropping. Right now it's a 5 mile an hour turn. When I mentioned that, they said, well, that intersection or that curve is the bridge. And I guess I should have realized that. And he mentioned again, you're going to have to suggest something like this to them.
Well, can I ask one thing? You always mention people.
Yes.
Can you give us the two names to say, Lori and Joe, a little bit of time? So if you've already talked to them, and they say, remember when you talked about Friar so-and-so?
Yes, right.
Okay, can you please give us the names?
I thought I did.
Well, Aaron, you just mentioned two engineers just now. Can
Sure.
Give us this, who
sure.
Are they?
Todd Kravitz.
Okay.
And Zach and
what was that again?
I'm not talking to you.
Okay, so if you could please bring those names and the spelling of their names, just so we'd be able to.
Well, sure. I'm sure they're going to be the two guys.
Let's make sure, because then we're wasting more time.
Oh, fine.
Every time you mention I've talked to this person or that person, it's just a generalized. If you could please give us the physical name.
I just did.
But what was the second one? I didn't even hear the
K-O-M-I-N-K-R-I, I believe. I'm quite sure.
If you believe this time, so the next time you come, if you could please make sure you bring the actual name.
I'm quite sure when you get to the meeting next week, they'll know exactly who the individual is.
But I'm asking you, please, the next time you come and you mention you're talking to people, please give us the names of who you are.
I have no hesitation.
Okay, great, thank you.
Yeah, one other thing. I think, I don't know if it was the last time, but the time before, when I was talking about the importance of the left turn, and if they do create a new curb on the right side. Hey guys, let me tell you something. Stop trying to interfere with my right to speak here. Do you understand that? This is the third time. I'm not putting up with it anymore. These are important issues that you guys should have notified PennDOT, and you didn't, according to them. So I don't want to hear.
That's not true.
Yeah, right. Well, anyway, let me finish. We'll decide. There might be another opportunity where we can all decide if it's true or not. Okay. But anyway, my point is, I think the last time I was here, I pointed out that if PennDOT does build a new curb with where the sidewalks deteriorated in front of that, I guess that's the east curb in front of that drugstore, excuse me, that means that you have an opportunity to create landscaping on both sides of the street and also extend the traditional street lights that end at the post office from continuing from the post office down to the new bridge. The last time, I think Lori mentioned something about it. You guys had talked about it. I think there are 14 poles or lights required there. I think Lori mentioned something about you were thinking about 7. What's the status of that? Are you looking into some funding for that? Are you looking into combining the wider left turn, the new curb, the new sidewalks, the new trees, and the lighting, all one package, so it would be a rather spectacular result, and the bigger the result, the better the funding, the people that run the funding sources like it. You aren't going to get any money from them with a compromising, subdued type plan. I just want to mention that to you. Lori, you mentioned that you checked into it the last time I was there.
As far as the funding, most times, Lori, correct me if wrong, the borough has to contribute as well. Is that correct?
Right.
So as far as trying to make sure that we can reach our budgets, we need to make sure that we can reach our budgets and do that funding.
Right.
So just want to make sure that we have to then figure out how to find even more money.
Right. Because right now,
if it's a bigger fund, that means you have to come up with more. Is that correct?
Right.
Yeah, of course. Right. Excuse me for interrupting, Lori. But have you gotten as far as determining what the overall cost of the lights, the planting of the trees, and the electrical access to the upper?
No.
Don't you think you ought to do that now before?
Not that far. No.
Yeah, okay. As long as you guys feel there's still time to add that feature. Thank you.
One of the items that was brought up last meeting regarding the left turn on Chartier Street, and Mary brought it on the table again. It would be good to have a left turn up off of Washington up Chartier Street. Was a decision by council to ask for a letter to go to PennDOT. Has that letter been written, and if so, can we get a copy of it?
You sent it a long time ago.
Yeah.
Right after the June meeting.
No, it was been longer than that, Pat. It's been some time.
No, because we've asked for that left-hand turn.
All along, we've been looking for the task force.
Yeah. Could you get us a copy? I'd like to see a copy. Okay, but it would be good to see a copy of that. I know that our original plans that Mike Haberman wrote up did not have a left turn going up Chartier Street off of Washington. It specifically did not have that feature. And it...
Left turn onto Chartiers.
Onto Chartiers off of Washington, because that required additional width, and we were reluctant at the beginning. There seems to be consensus around doing
it. We've asked several times.
Yeah, we have.
Well, if you have something to document that we've asked, that would be most helpful. If you can't, maybe just write another one, because write another one. Ask again. It won't hurt.
Yeah.
Because you had it at the last meeting. You agreed to do that.
We're talking. We have a meeting next week, and that's what we want to
do. Right.
Thanks, Pat. All right. Moving on to regular meeting.
Motion to Borough Council regarding the minutes of the June 12, 2017 regular meeting as submitted.
So move. Second.
Bruce and Bert, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Ordinance number 997, motion of the Borough Council regarding ordinance number 997, an ordinance amending the zoning ordinance to establish updated rules for lighting, parking, parking structures, design standards, and setbacks. Public hearing was held earlier today, July 10, 2017, at 6 p.m. to receive citizens' comments, and the ordinance has been duly advertised. There was some discussion about this ordinance, and there was, I think there was one thing we talked about in keeping the original lighting standards the way they are. And I believe we can still, if the council approves it, we can move forward with just without the lighting standards, correct?
Yes, and that would be Article 1, Section B of the ordinance draft. So if that was the way one wanted to proceed, they could propose that the draft ordinance be with that stricken, with the Section B stricken, that the remainder of the proposed amendments be enacted.
Okay. So that addresses Kay Pierce's issue from the county?
Yeah, and that's just a technical issue. Yeah, and we talked, on the hearing. There's actually, you could go three ways. Look at her suggestions, and after going to hearing, engineer sites looked at it, and I think the consensus was actually our existing standards court. So we're just not going to take action on that section, and it'll stay in place the way it is.
All right. Is there a motion?
So moved.
Second.
And Bert, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed?
And if the recording secretary slash manager could have the final text reflect that Section 1B has been stricken from the final text before enacted.
Motion carries. Before moving on, I just want to recognize Tim Knapp, Nina Petruselli, and Dale Livingston, who put a lot of time and effort into the design standards over the winter, and they did a really good job. We should be commended for that. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Resolution number 2017-6, motion of the Borough Council regarding resolution number 2017-6, resolution opposing the elimination of the Community Development Block Grant Program.
So move.
Bill?
Go ahead if you get a second.
All right.
Comment
second.
Because
second. And Joe, a comment?
I do not believe we should oppose the elimination of a vast bureaucratic program coming down from Washington. The CDBG money that we get, it's very nice, but let's not forget that it was our tax dollars that we sent to Washington, and after going through a vast bureaucracy, were sent back to us to do some interesting projects, right, Lori? I mean, we've had a number of houses that have been, torn down based on their funding.
Yeah.
We've had ADA compliant ramps put in based on their funding.
Oh yeah, the travel charges work.
Yeah, I mean, it's very nice. And what the bureau, what, I don't know, where did, who, how did this end up? Who sent us the idea of putting this on the agenda?
The COG.
Okay. And of course the COG is getting that from, I would take it, the county. It's a very, very intertwining group of administration that supports sending money to the federal government to have it percolate back down to us, and by the time we get it, we have less control over it, and there's less money available. So I, for one, am hopeful that they eliminate the entire CDBG program. Or at least that they change it so dramatically that it actually does target communities that need it, rather than trying to spread the money back out over the United States of America, in a thin veneer. Because it doesn't do a whole lot of good the way it's working. So I'm hopeful the council will not pass the resolution.
Any other comments? How much, you may know, just cost us a year? I mean, if you're saying we donate or we kick money towards it.
We don't pay towards it, right? It's our tax dollars, it's our tax dollars.
So if we didn't have this, money wouldn't come in through that grant.
If you listen to the news with the budget and the state, money from the state is practically gone.
Right.
So I mean, eventually we're going to be on our own. And Bridgeville, I don't think, can cut all the projects we want to do. We need help, I mean, from the federal government, from the state, from the county. And I don't have a problem with it, and I think we should pass it, so.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Current estimate number one, 2016 sanitary sewer repair contract A. Motion to Borough Council regarding renewal of current estimate number one, 2016 sanitary sewer repair contract A to Solar Construction in the amount of $76,345.74 for the work completed to date. Estimate has been reviewed by engineer Sykes.
So, Bruce?
Bruce.
And Bert, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Pollutant reduction plan, MS4 permit. Motion to Borough Council authorizing manager Collins to advertise the pollutant reduction plan as required for the MS4 permit submission to the DEP in September 2017. The plan must be publicly advertised for 30 days prior to the adoption within 15 additional days to receive public comment.
So moved.
Bert? Second?
Second.
And Bill, all those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. Bill list, motion of Borough Council regarding the 2017 bill list.
I'll move.
Joe?
Second.
And Bert, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Payrolls, motion to Borough Council approving payrolls of July 14, 2021, 2028, and August 4 and 11, 2017.
So moved.
Bruce?
Second.
And Joe? Also, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Monthly reports, motion to accept the payment commissions due June 2017 real estate tax collector report.
I'll move.
Joe Rucci?
Second.
And Bruce, all those in favor?
Aye.
Motion carries. All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept the May 2017 financial report.
I'll move.
Joe Rucci?
Second.
And Bruce Dalrucci, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. A motion to accept the June 2017 police report.
So moved.
Bill Henderson?
Second.
And Joe Glasgow, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Motion to accept the June 2017 zoning report.
So moved.
Is it Bill Henderson?
Second.
And Bert Cherry, all those in favor?
Aye.
All those opposed? Motion carries. Committee reports. Bruce?
I have nothing, sir.
Finance, Joe?
Nothing really to report other than Lori and her staff have continued to support and help collect some of the back taxes that are still due. Another 5% work went down, so excellent work of continuing to collect what we need to collect so we don't have those back taxes sitting not being used. So happy to see that.
Thanks. Parks and Recreation, Joe?
This short little report here. We had an opportunity to have a birthday party for my grandson down at Tractor's Park. Sort of commercial for the park. It's been beautiful down there. We did have a situation, the restroom's backed up. And Public Works has a person on call all the time. They were down there within an hour, got everything cleaned up. So it was really nice. We want to have an affair down at Tractor's Park. The clock was closed right now, anticipating construction. Love Cook School, and it's a good place to have a park. Anything like that, birthdays or whatever. also, Bridgeville Day. I just want to quickly thank everybody that I know that was involved in the thing. Lori, Lynette, Cheryl Valentino, she's the ramrod. She basically runs the thing. She really gets things going. Public Works Department, Police Department, and the volunteer people like the Fire Department, John McCant and Pat Vogel from Pittsburgh Cars, Mitch Gelson, Mary Weiss, Leona Salfrey, and especially Elizabeth Mansfield. She busted her butt out there on the street this year. Without those people, it couldn't be done. But basically, this thing runs itself really anymore. I mean, the people do the work, but it's like clockwork anymore, the way the borough, the office folks, and everything get things going. So again, thanks to them for everything, all their help. And also, a lesson from the newsletter editor, deadlines this week. Anybody has any information for the newsletter, please get it to Deb or the borough sometime this week. That's it. Thank you.
Thanks, Joe. Public Works, Bruce.
Nothing, sir.
Public Safety.
Yeah, just continued props to the Chief of the Police Department for the use of social media. If you're not following, you should be, because this past month was, in addition to the traffic situations, he's alerting us to some crime occurring, I think an armed robbery that the public gets involved in. So props to you guys, but props to the community, too, for supporting it and giving them feedback and helping them do their job as well. So thanks.
Thanks, Bill. Mr. Mayor.
Hospitality is going to occur again this year on the 22nd of July. It's a very nice festival. It is a joint effort in Bridgeville and South Fayette, and it occurs, as I say, on the 22nd. And that's pretty much all I have.
Thank you. Police Chief Chuck King.
Thank you, Council President. Started off on Community Day. We had over 100 bicycle helmets donated to the department through UPMC and Kohl's, their Hardhead program. And within 90 minutes, we had given away over 100 bicycle helmets on Community Day. I think we also gave out every gun lock that we had, which was in the area of 300 to 500, and several hundred snap bracelets also. So that was pretty successful. We are out of resources. We're going to have to restock for next year. To touch on the robbery on June 21st, the armed robbery at Rite Aid, that occurred at about 8:48 in the morning. We received the call. After processing the scene, once we arrived, I put a Facebook message out at about 10:25 a.m. Instantly, that goes to over 6,000 followers that we have, and within 10 minutes, I had the first credible identification on the suspect through the photo that we received from Rite Aid. In all, the post in 6 hours reached 124,825 people. It was shared 1,400 times, and we had over 40 people identify the robbery suspect just from that one post, including his own mother, his current girlfriend, who said, "I bought him that sweater for Christmas," and the mother of his child.
He must be a winner.
So he's created his share of problems throughout his life, I guess. But we had him in custody by 4:30 that evening, I believe. And the deal I made with his girlfriend was, because a lot of people have asked where did the post go, I told her I would delete the post after he turned himself in, brought the clothes he wore, the vehicle he used, and confessed. And he confessed to two armed robberies, one that we had and one that we had in Scott Township 2 days earlier. He robbed the dollar store in Scott Township. He even, just to let you know too, the camera systems, different camera systems that we have in town, Rite Aid has a great camera system inside. They have a high-def camera. The camera system at Bethany Church also helped us, because I'd call your township officers, go over and access those cameras. They could see the actor when he came out of the store. Before he went in, we thought he changed the license plate out on his car. But when he went down 50, he turned right to get on the interstate. South Fayette has traffic cams, high-def traffic cams mounted to the lights. You could actually see he bent both corners of the license plate up so you couldn't identify the plate. So it was a good effort amongst all the departments, South Fayette handling their cameras, Collier coming down, assisting us, Scott Township was here, even an Upper St. Clair officer, he's a car nut, he's the one that identified the type of car that he was in. But ultimately, it comes down to social media. Our last three armed robberies over the last 3 years have all been solved due to Facebook. So it works, it's a powerful tool.
Thank you, Chief. Solicitor.
Thank you.
Thank you. You're my written report. But I have been spending some time since the public section of the meeting searching for examples of pet ordinance enhancements. And if you'd like somebody who could enhance our ordinance with such things that enhance our leash law, enhance our cleanup requirements. Our old school ordinance probably didn't have them because you didn't need them, those folks didn't. You know, apparently you need them and they're becoming in vogue. So, you know, we could add something that affirmatively states the obvious, clean up your stuff immediately. You know, if that would be something you want to suggest that I could do that.
Okay. Thanks.
That's all.
Engineer, your sites.
Thank you, Mr. President. You approved the payment to Soil and Construction for the sanitary sewer port repairs. And AAA Pipe Clean is continuing inspecting the internal inside of the sanitary sewer that leads into the backflow preventer project. We're currently working on the design specifications for backflow preventers. And AAA Pipe Clean has the ability to inspect the laterals. So we've asked them to take a look at the interested property owners' laterals so we can establish the scope of work of each lateral. And then that'll help us with our scope of work. And then we can finalize the bid documents. You approved the pollution reduction plan, which works with the MS4 permit. The whole purpose of this plan is to reduce the nutrients and sediments that are getting into the waters of the Commonwealth. You approved the advertisement. The plan indicates some possibilities of going about to reduce the sediment load. One thing that's not in this report, and I apologize, and I'll get it down here in the water, is the fourth measure is using our street sweeping. We sweep the streets already. We might as well get some credit for reducing our pollutant load by keeping track of how much debris we pick up. You know, a bottle here, a bag here doesn't amount to much, but it's the dirt that we're looking for. And probably we will get a lot of dirt up in the spring after our winter snow removal and salt and cinder. So that'll help also. So there's four options. We can meet that requirement and be in line with it the next 5 years to satisfy that. Paving maintenance program, I've been in communication with Dunwood Paving. We'll be scheduling a pre-construction meeting with them before the end of July. The Bower Hill Road, I met with People's Gas. They're in agreement with sharing the cost associated with Bower Hill Road. Met with T.A. Robinson, they're looking for the back end of July. Norfolk Farm Park, I've been trying to get a hold of the guy at the state regarding our plan and specifications. I'm going to be off the rest of this week, so I'll continue when I get back on vacation.
He's holding up.
Washington James Development, Lori and I met with the architect to review their latest design. I will say this is a very complimentary design that they've come forward with. It's not a glass palace anymore. It has elements of glass and masonry that complement each other. It has a port, like a deck on the roof. It has an inset front first floor. It's really complementary to the surrounding architecture of Bridgeville Borough, so I think it'll fit in very nice. So they're in the process, and I think we'll all be satisfied. And then Chartier Street, Washington Avenue, and Chartier Creek Bridge intersection, the Route 50 Task Force. We had requested a task force meeting with PennDOT since the district executive had left and went to work for Michael Baker. He was one of our very good supporters of looking for other sources of funding for the project. So Todd Kravitz and Cheryl Moon Cerami had graciously agreed to meet with us and McCormick Taylor, the design consultant, next week at PennDOT to review what they have to date. So we'll have an update for you in August. So.
Thanks, Joe. Bill Chilio, fire chief, is not here. Southbridge, Dan.
Thank you, Mr. President. I want to apologize to the board for missing the last couple meetings. I did bring stats for June tonight with me. I will give Gloria to hand out to y'all later, and other than that, I have nothing to report.
Thank you. I'll see Becky from the library here. Borough manager.
I supplied my written report for you. Also, I just, I had sent over some analytics regarding our new website. Since April, when we launched it, there were 202 users in April, and as far as June goes, we have 2017 users coming to the site now. I have a meeting with the designer to launch our Facebook page, so we'll also be doing a Facebook page. So that should be launched probably within the next month. But we're getting a lot more traffic. We're doing some advertising, and we're advertising the text alerts. So that's moving along and getting more popular, so.
Great.
It seemed that whenever the last newsletter came up, that blip was right around.
And also on Community Day, it was really well used on Community Day, so.
Good. All right. Well,
that's all I have, unless anybody has any questions.
Old business? New business?
I have two things. The Southwest Communities Chamber is still selling those tickets. I have heard that the max out on the tickets is 750, so one out of 750, so you get that truck in a 3-year lease for $18,000. To my understanding, they're nowhere close to that 750, so your odds are even higher of winning those tickets. Just stop down at the branch if you're interested in the building, if you're interested in buying tickets, or I can get you some tickets. The second thing is, it was made public that Emerald Van Buskirk and Barb are both separating from the chamber. They're looking to move on. So therefore, we're in the process of, as the chamber board, looking to hire the next person. So if anybody is interested in applying for that position, just go to our website or Facebook page. Everybody knows that we're going to big shoes to fill with Emerald and Barb at that office. But they are having a farewell social event for Emerald on July 27th. At the Crown Plaza on Fort Couch Road near the village. It is at, again, the Crown Plaza from 5 to 7, a little happy hour kind of day to bid farewell to Emerald and Barb, who will be truly missed. So if anybody would like to come, please give the chamber a call just to let them know. They're trying to get numbers in line to make sure that they're having hors d'oeuvres and little things as well as open cash flow.
Any other new business? Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second. All in favor? All opposed? Aye.
So, we're going to take the 8 o'clock in.